my position is communications secretary of the Black Panther Party, and I work directly with the Minister of Information of the Black Panther Party. We're building what we call the Ministry of Information, which would deal with the whole aspect of getting out information, publications, newspaper, magazines, pamphlets, contacts with the press, arranging distribution of literature, arranging printing, building tape libraries, building libraries, making sure there's printed publications, this type of thing. My husband is Minister of Information. Black people, in general, are responsive to what we say, especially young black people. And the white people that invite us, they're curious, or they want information in the Peace and Freedom Party, and they're usually very grateful because the Black Panther Party has a rational program and a rational explanation for the many confusing things that are happening around the country. So whereas you might invite some speakers who rant and rave and talk about hate white people, burn, kill, etc., and they can't really understand it, they can't isolate it, the Black Panther Party will give an ideological perspective and separate the institutions from the citizens, the government from the people, and point out the institutions, this particular pig, the police department, the educational system, the economic system, to be attacked. And to not attack the individuals because of color, this skin, this skin, this skin, this skin. This brother here, myself, all of us were born with our hair like this, and we just wear it like this because it's natural, because the reason for it, you might say, is like a new awareness among black people that their own natural appearance, physical appearance, is beautiful. It's pleasing to them. The women want to please men, and if men accept it as beautiful, then women will do it. Like this. Dig it? Isn't it beautiful?
Yes.
All right.